We're here to talk about the ScopeMeter 125B BusHealth Mode. Right now I've got the ScopeMeter hooked up to a demo board using this STL120 one-to-one probe. If you're measuring an RS-232 signal, then you'll only need the one probe. If you're measuring, say for example, CAN bus, where you have a high and a low, you're gonna need the other STL120 probe, which both of these are included in the kit, the blue and the red. If you're measuring interbus S, then you'll need the VPS or VP21 probes, which are the 10-to-1. And if for whatever reason you're not able to hook up to the signal using these types of probes, then we have the BHT190 adapter that will help you hook up to your system. To get to BusHealth mode, press the menu button and then use the arrow key to scroll down to BusHealth. Once you have it highlighted, press the Enter key. You can see here a list of communications that you can choose from. For this demonstration, we're gonna take a look at RS-232. Once you have it highlighted, press Enter. You can see here these dash marks indicate that there's no reading at this time. And up here on the left is the communication that you're measuring. And right below it are your activity dots. And so the first circle, if it's solid green, means you're measuring a voltage. The second and third circle, if they're blinking between white and green, that means you have activity and communication. You'll notice here V-level high shows an exclamation mark. That means that the reading is between 80 to 100% of the allowable range. And if it's got a check mark, then your reading is okay. You also notice that the cycle symbol is appearing next to each test. That indicates which test it's executing right at that moment. So let's mess with the setup limits by pressing F1. You can see here there's an asterisk next to V level high. That's because I went in and I manually changed one of the limits. I actually changed the low limit so that we could see the exclamation mark symbol. So we'll go in and we'll edit the low limit again by pressing F1. This time we'll change it to 8 so that a regular RS-232, and then press F4 for done and F4 for done again. And now we have an X, and that means it's outside of the allowable range. If you press F3, you can see the eye pattern. And in this screen, the waveform is shown for 1 bit time, and it's triggered on the positive and negative. And you'll notice here that your eye is wide open and it's nice and clean looking. So that means you have a good signal. If you press F3, you can see the real-time version of the waveform. Now let's see what happens if we mess with the signal. So I'm gonna intentionally put a poor signal on there, some noise. And you'll see here in this real-time waveform screen that there's some ringing and there's overshoot. If we press F3 once, twice to get back to the eye pattern, your eye pattern is no longer clean, wide open. If you press the hold run, it'll pause. And then if you press F1 to clear the persistent waveform, and then hold run again, it'll start the bit collection again.
That wraps up the ScopeMeter 125B BusHealth mode demonstration.